we are in the, again, the Badlands, let's call it the Badlands, I've been there for 20-some years. And more recently, in my new building, the last 10 years, I'm at 10th and Butler, which is right one block north of Erie Avenue on 10th Street. We also have electric fences, but we've done a lot to do, we've done a lot of things with neighborhoods besides hiring people from the neighborhood who would ordinarily not get jobs anywhere. I want to touch on something that nobody in this building knows other than maybe a couple of water people. And it's an important piece because I think this is what stirred up the whole thing. At one time, I lived in the Philadelphia, which is the apartment house just adjacent from the art museum. I lived there for a bunch of years. And eventually, at one point, I was asked to join the board, and I was on the board. I ran for office, and I was on the board there. We had a problem, not just the Philadelphia, but 2601, the Philadelphian, the Parkway House, and all the other towers all over the city. And the problem was that when they built all these buildings, and I believe the 1940 or the 50s, the 2601 was built, the size of the water meter was extremely large, larger than what they needed to support the water usage in the building. The Philadelphia has 769 apartments, including office buildings on the first floor. And this was a problem when I got on the board, that the fees were extremely high for the usage. Again, you have an apartment house, you have a roof, it's three sections, the Philadelphia, which faces the art museum. And the water on the roof, you know, we have a small roof, but we also have seven, I guess closer to 1,000 toilets. My building, I have 12 toilets. And my building, I have some urinals, and that's all the water we use. My bill is $300-some a month. It will now go to $4,000 a month. But getting back to the Philadelphia, they complain, and the association for all the high rises and parking lots complain that they were paying too much money for water. The water department agreed and said, "You're right. We have to kind of spread this out." Hence, I believe that this was the beginning of this whole thing. This is what started. And there was no thought. They did not let businessmen know. We were told that they spent $100,000 advertising. And Jack Kramer, who happened to run the deli, and he owns no property that I know in the city of Philadelphia. He rents. He's in the deli business. And he's the only one that showed up. One businessman. Yes, they call Roman Haas, they may have called Tasty Cake and people like that. They have to call the businessman, the one who's going to get squeezed the most. The in-between guy, the wholesaler, the distributor. And that's what you have with people behind you. You have real estate people. And the water tax is what it's really called. They call it an assessment. It's not an assessment, it's a tax. We get nothing for it. It's also protected, if you look at the Sterling Act of 1932. Check on page 8, on page 65. Okay? I've read it. It's illegal what they're doing. It is not legal to just tax people and not give them anything more for their taxes. Do something. Provide a service. Do something different. Do something different. If they're going to spend the money on the water system and change the sewers, the underground, the infrastructure, that's one thing. That's not what is happening. They're depending on the businessman. And no one's touched about the wages and the people in the neighborhoods who will be out of work if we go belly up or have to move. That's all I have to say. Thank you for everything, and thank you to Teresa Italiano for helping bring us here. Thank you, gentlemen.
Good morning, my name is Weston Kirk, and I'm the property manager for WT, the real estate management company. I represent the Thackeray family, Thackeray Kramer. Thackeray's been in Philadelphia for over 75 years. I'm sure if you've seen a Thackeray Kramer before, you've seen it built on the lake working on City Hall, putting up the Comcast building. I think you know what kind of service we provide in the city of Philadelphia. Extreme amount of loyalty as well. Our properties are industrial properties. Some are owner-occupied, some tenant-occupied. Our company, the majority of our tenants, mostly consist of businesses in the construction, property owner, repair, maintenance, and distribution industries. And we employ lower to middle income people, also known as blue collar folks. We have jobs like crane operator, truck driver, mechanic, machinist, handler, secretary, processor, and janitor. What we consider a big business may employ 50 to 100 people, and there are dozens of small businesses that employ only two or three people that only exist to provide services to these larger businesses. Over the past 3 years now, I've seen several of these small businesses, some of them are tenants.